somebody here to the first 1,000 persons at the end of this conference. They will refer to you as the miracle of this meeting. Talking about Yeshua and Mashiach, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Tipera. We don't serve a dead God, we serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday, he's the same today, he's the same forever.
Glory is on your side,
amen.
Favor is on your side,
amen.
Lift your hands, shall
we? I came this morning as a son of the oracle. I decree, after this service, there's a marital level coming, there's a business level coming.
Somebody hear what I said? The devil's. There are people who are workers of the devil on earth. The way we say we are men of God, there are men of the devil. There are women of the devil. In Job, the Bible says, when the sons of God gather, even what? Satan also came. And I preached a message some time ago, and Satan goes to church. The reason why you left your bag free was because you feel you were in the house of God. But when you came back to look at the bag, you discovered that your phone was missing. You can't come to terms because you just can't imagine how somebody will take your phone in the church. Why? You came with the mind of an angel, with the fear of God, but there's somebody who came as a satanic agent. Am I speaking to somebody here? Is somebody hearing what I'm saying?
Yes,
so
sir.
I need every one of us to understand that there are men of God and there are men of the devil. Until it comes on you as a consciousness, you may not address some fundamental matters. Hello, church. Am I talking to somebody? In Genesis chapter 2, God, after making the garden, began to bless man. Let's multiply. Do this. Do you know the devil don't show up until God shows up? When God is decorating you, there is a devil that wants to disdecorate you. I don't know if I'm saying something. Genesis chapter 2, God was all about man. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 1, as soon as God was true, and the Bible said they were both naked, the last verse of Genesis chapter 2, and they were both naked and they were not ashamed. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 1, the devil appeared. The Bible said the devil was more subtle. Huh? And that was how man fell. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 15, God now put enmity between the woman and Satan. Am I speaking to somebody? We are going to pray. Whoever is causing enmity between me and my helpers. Am I speaking to somebody here? Huh? Can I talk to you? When did the devil came? When did he appear to Jesus? After he finished fasting. Is it true? Just to rubbish effort. He came to rubbish his effort. So that the glory of the prize will not be seen. Do you know that as we are here now, there are some of you happy that I'm 10 years in marriage. There are some that are angry. You don't know why you are angry. It's because you are the devil's worker. You need deliverance. No, you can't explain why you are angry. Oh. Yes. You just see somebody's car, you are angry. Do you wish that somebody will keep begging you to eat? A boy must grow. Am I speaking to somebody? No. It's a major problem in church, witchcraft in church. I'm not talking about here because God is helping us. Am I talking at all? You know, I said number one, always speaking against positive or good things is a sign that you are the devil's employee. This time somebody is just, maybe somebody, your delight is to you contribute more when they bring the negative news of a person. But you don't have contribution when it's, that brother just bought the car, move. Thank the Lord. But as soon as they come, say, ah, that woman, you know, yeah, I think they said that they pray. They said that they, you don't start topic, you are an employee. Let me start opening up for those who need deliverance. Am I talking here? Number two is an accuser of the brethren. Is a characteristic of the devil. You keep accusing people. Accusing. Accusing. Each time you appear before authority, you accuse. I was thinking of helping that lady. You need to be careful. Be careful. They'll go meet your wife. Your husband is planning to marry second wife. You say, what do you mean? There's one lady. Are you allowing that girl to come and stay in your house? That one is not a housemaid, though. He will collect your man, no. Praise the Lord. Father, whoever is causing enmity between me and my helpers. Whoever, Papa said we should pray one prayer. Whoever is angry that I'm happy. Oh God that answers my father, reply them on my behalf. Open your mouth and turn it to praise.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Some time back, I had a meeting, and I saw a man and a wife, a woman who was heavy. And I said to them, I said, on the day of your delivery, let nobody know. Not because there was an enemy, but because there was an enemy. Am I speaking to someone? And when the wife delivered, as it were, how come you did not tell us? And one said, if you had told me, I would have done. You know, there are times, step on certain people's toes. That's when they confess which. When all of you are laughing, you don't know who is your friend. When you provoke somebody, he will say what he didn't want to say. That's why when you are provoking certain people, listen to their reply. They will confess the witch they didn't plan to confess. You want to know who is your friend? Provoke your environment. Scatter the water. Watch reactions. You know your own. Instantly. It may not be 100% true, but 80%. You'll get to know something. And I saw you do me that day. You stepped on me. You think I'm forgiving you. I've just been watching you in this church. Watch well. I prophesy.
I receive.
The God that has kept us, the God of my Father, Jesus Christ, the living one, he that was and is to come, I decree your testimony will not be aborted.
Amen.
I say your testimony will not be aborted.
Amen.
If your amen is loudest, you are the one I'm talking to.
Amen.
Jesus' name.